So when we talk about gravitation, it is very important to understand the fundamental concept of gravitation. Gravitation not only suggests that since we are living on the surface of the earth, we have a pull. That pull is known as gravity. But this is not the whole concept of gravitation. The concept of gravitation tells us that if a body has mass m, no matter how small or how big, the mass m is, each and every individual object which has a mass m will have a gravitational pull, that is, will always have a gravitational pull with respect to other objects. Now, let's try to clear some of the misconceptions that we have regarding gravity. If this is mass m and this is mass m1 and this is mass m2. This is mass m2, this is 1. Okay. So, because of this, I want to see the interaction between these two and interaction between these two. Now suppose the mass is same for both the cases, m and m. Now this will experience a gravitational force of F1, and this will also experience a gravitational force of F2. The distance between them are also same. See, suppose distance between them are also same. So gravity is something where the individual forces comes with, that is superposition principle. That is, superposition principle tells us that if M is experiencing a force due to F1 and M2 is experiencing a force of F2, so M in turn is experiencing a force of F1 plus F2. That is, he is experiencing a force that is the sum of all the other forces. So the net force that M is experiencing, is F1 plus F2. Now it does not matter how many objects we have. Say suppose this is M3. So the net force would have become F3. So the force that is experienced by this object due to all the other objects is the sum of all the individual forces. Say suppose this is F1, this is F2, this is F3, and so on. So the net force that has been experienced is the sum of all the individual forces that has been experienced by this two object. So this is one of the common misconceptions that students have. Say suppose these are three objects, we won't be finding just for one. Say this is the net gravitation force. No, this is strong. You have to find all the individual forces and you have to take the sum of all the net forces. This also falls under your superposition principle. So let's start gravity, that is gravitation, by understanding what is gravity. Now, the main contributor of gravity, you can give him the major contribution, and that is Kepler. So Kepler proposed some laws regarding gravity. So let's have a look as to what that law tells us. The first law that Kepler proposed was law of orbits. Law of orbits. What does this law of orbit mean? It means that all the planets move in an elliptical orbits, which all the planets move in elliptical orbits with the sun. Situated at one of its foci. So this is what Kepler's law of gravitation tells us. Now you may have a debate among Kepler and Newton as to who contributed more in the process of gravitation, but for heavenly bodies, Kepler was the major contribution. For all other laws, mechanical laws, Newton was the major contributor. So these two scientists contributed to make what we know of gravity and gravitation today. So let's try to explain Kepler's first law with proper diagram. Say suppose this is your sun. S is my sun. Let me make this more clear. If S is your sun and if this is my planet P, so this, if first let me draw an elliptical path. So if I draw this elliptical path, what I see is that, okay, this ellipse will have two focal lengths. As we know from geometry, ellipse has two focal lengths, that is, one is f1 and other is f2. So if there is a planet and there is sun, and if the planet revolves in a elliptical path and the position of the sun and the position of the sun is situated in among one of the two foci, among one of the two foci, the position of the sun is situated. This is one of the foci and this is another one of the foci. So this is what Kepler's law of orbits tells us. Let me explain this to you in another diagram. This is an ellipse. If you have any doubt regarding the geometrical aspect of ellipse, so please consult the geometrical part of the video. So this is an ellipse and it has two focal lengths. This is f1 and this is f2. So if a planet is taking this path, that is an ellipse path around the sun, so the sun should be located in one of the foci, either this foci or this foci. Excuse me. So this is what Kepler's first law of orbits tells us.